Azioni School of Regulation since 2015, we have started to study how regulation should cope with the digital markets and digital platform. And the first step we decided to take has been the microeconomic analysis of these particular market players, the platforms. We recognize that the main pillars of this new form of market players are the granularity and the underutilization of assets from one side, the pulverization and customization of the needs from the other side, and finally, the network effect that act like a support of market evolution. We have recognized also different kinds of platforms of the so-called platform economy that we prefer not to call sharing economy, because sharing has nothing to do with selling, and the platform economy has mainly engaged in selling or renting things and services. Well, the main categories of this kind of new market players, not in hierarchical order, are first the typical consumer platform that help consumers to gain market power in the oligopsonistic sense, in order to buy goods at a discounted price, for example. And normally they cover a very little share of market and are managed on a voluntary basis. Second, much more bigger, the platforms that intermediate between buyers and sellers, both individuals and firms, and take a fee for each deal that is concluded. And third, the platform that allows people to interact socially, the social media platform that generally don't take fees from consumers, but has a structure of revenues completely different. Well, on this new world of digital markets and digital platforms, COVID has entered in a very, very disrupting way, changing the landscape in a positive sense, or positive for the firms, for platforms that move goods and services toward the consumer's house, and penalizing in a very hard way platforms that interact but need the consumer moving to the good for buying it, or to the service, a room, a house, or a personal services. So the first category has been violently benefited by COVID, and the second one has been dramatically hit. The regulatory challenge that face public policies are mainly three. The first one is the possibility of abuse of market power, in particular by platforms that combine the role of intermediation and the role of gatekeeper. Obviously, Amazon is the best example. Amazon is a middleman, but at the same time is a market player, and it can obstruct, move, and use in an opportunistic way the huge amount of data it collects from supplier and from buyers. The second regulatory challenge is about acquisitions. Acquisitions that can kill competition in a particular sector. We have already seen it for Google, Amazon, Facebook, acquisition of WhatsApp and things like that. And the third regulatory challenge is for sure the question of data ownership, data extraction and data management. The three are big, big challenges and regulation that has been traditionally applied to traditional physical services like electricity, water, waste, local public transport, with the traditional instrument of the regulatory policy, price cap, revenue cap, internal rate of return, and so on, is in a way not completely ready to face the new challenges. But also antitrust policy need an overhaul, because traditional antitrust have considered in particular the final effect on price of a particular market position. But we know that for digital markets, the final effect on price can hide very, very problematic situation of market abuse and market distortion. Antitrust and regulation have been traditionally sisters, but they have alternate cooperation and conflict about instrument to be used and also about the field of application. Our opinion at Tuning School of Regulation is that in the future, we don't know exactly what will be the landscape in 1 year or 2 years. We are in time of extreme uncertainties. But we for sure know that antitrust and regulation need to be good sisters in the future to cope with these challenges. Tuning School of Regulation for the first year has suspended our flagship initiative, the Summer School on Regulation, that traditionally happened in September. We have postponed it to 2021 for obvious reasons. But we are not blocked, because we are preparing a very huge and, I hope, interesting amount of contents, online contents, in the next months, in particular, a series of web seminars on digital markets and on regulatory challenges, and a series of interview with privileged witness, scholars, managers about the evolution of the digital and traditional services after the lockdown and after the reopening phase. So I hope that all of you will enjoy these contents and keep in touch. Bye from Franco Becchis. I am the scientific director of Tuning School of Regulation. Thank you.